Hello dear viewers, myself Shivam Pandgale and my project members are Mr. Shloka Stekar, Mr. Siddhesh Gadge and Mr. Prajwal Mane. So in this video, we are going to explain our capstone project work. So our topic is design and development of autonomous floor cleaning machine. Professor Arun Meshram sir is our project guide. He guided and cooperated us in all the possible ways of helping. So we are heartily thankful to him for such support. In this presentation, we are going to overlook autonomous floor cleaning machine along with its working components, construction, 3D models and design. First, let we know what is autonomous floor cleaner. So, autonomous floor cleaner is a machine which cleans the whole area without human interface. Automatic floor cleaner is basically combination of mechanical and electronic field. So, we can call it as mechatronics based project. The first floor cleaner was discovered by a person named James Dyson in 1997. We see many different types of automatic floor cleaning machines available there in market, but a Sweden company named Electrolux were the first who developed new concept of floor cleaning solutions for industrial hospitals and housekeeping applications, etc. Here is literature review. The floor cleaning machine was first introduced by Electrolux, as I mentioned in the previous slide. A new automatic floor cleaner robot called Mint was developed by Jeff Seffen in early 2010. The problem we found in current automatic floor cleaning machines is that they are only used for only dry and wet cleaning, but not for infection removal. Another point is that the automatic mops used to clean floor is like Hydrobot, which is specific floor cleaner have big mops, and they also require great power and can be only used for commercial purpose. Another problem we notice with other floor cleaning machines is that they are unable to clean the corners of the room, which is also part of floor because of their circular shape. So we decided to make square shape of whole machine, and only some portion of the mops is allowed to clean corner outside the machine. We will see its construction in further slides. This is problem definition. The story behind the making of this project has very problems which we observed in surroundings. The first thing we observed that people in this 21st century have very busy life due to their long working times. So in these situations, people find ways to save their valuable time. As we know, in the past era, floor was cleaned by traditional methods, which take more time. That's why that manual work is replaced by robotic work in the present era. Also, these autonomous robots available in markets are more expensive than the working salary of homemades. Also, maintenance of these robots is high. Now, I request my colleague to present further slides.
As I had been introduced at start of presentation, I am Siddhesh Gadge. We will be explaining you the working principle of autonomous floor cleaning machine. So the machine operates on the principle of point of equilibrium, or in a horizontal position to floor. So the machine will hover the same spot. So the machine works on few simple steps. First, simply power on the machine by using power switch. Our project works on two modes. First, manual mode, and second, autonomous mode. Now, in manual mode, we operate machine with the help of Bluetooth module, which is then controlled by mobile application. Then in automatic mode, it will run automatically by means of IR sensor, that is infrared sensor, which avoid obstacle. Now I request my colleague Shloka Stekar to briefly explain.
So now I would like to start with the explanation for the cross-sectional view of our floor cleaning machine. Here in the slide, we are clearly able to locate a layout of floor cleaning machine, which comprises of electronic as well as mechanical components. As we are clearly able to observe that all the mechanical as well as electronic components are mounted on the same chassis. Here in the next slide, we are able to see a 3D model of chassis which has been created in Creo Parametric 3.2, and the figure opposite to the 3D model image, we are able to see the composite sheet which is been used as a chassis in our project. A composite sheet is made up from composition of two or more elements Here in this case of composition is of 0.12 mm of aluminium on the both side, and in between core recycled polythene is used. This composite sheet are durable and are able to sustain large amount of load, and the bending due to load applied is also less, and it is also cheaper in rate. Here in the next slide, we are able to see exploded view of our vacuum cleaner mechanism, which simply made up from materials like PVC pipe, cotton as a filter, net for the output of air, 775 RPM brushless motor, which works on 12 volt supply, and blades made with lightweight material. Working principle of vacuum cleaner mechanism, it works on the principle of flow air from area of high pressure to area of low pressure. An electric motor is attached to a fan that spins it at highest velocity. Hence, the fast spinning fan creates a region of low pressure, that is negative pressure, inside the suction hose of vacuum mechanism, which creates vacuum. Here in the next slide, we are able to see the 3D models of vacuum cleaner mechanism, which are been created in cryoparametric 3.0. In the next slide, we are able to see a 3D water tank, which is been created in cryoparametric 3.0, which also has the capacity of round about 600 ml of water holding capacity. Which is made from a PVC pipe.
Resource used for development: electronic component like different types of sensors, motors, switches, drive module, rainbow wires and mega Arduino. Auxiliary components like PVC pipes, nuts, bolt, drill bit, hacksaw cutter, sheet cutter, tape, adhesive, composite board, foam board, flow control valve, water tube, etc. Machine used for development: radial drilling machine, hand drilling machine, power hacksaw machine, grinding machine, portable grinding, soldering machine, etc. Measuring instrument used for development: vernier caliper, electronic spirit level, set square, sheet ruler, etc.
In this slide, we are able to see cost estimation table. The table consists of part name and estimation cost of different parts. First, electronic component with estimated cost of 6482. Second, auxiliary parts consisting of PVC pipes, nut and bolt, etc., with estimation cost of 815. Third, composite board, foam board with estimated cost of 590. Fourth, flow center valve, water tube with estimated cost of 150. And the last total amount is 8037. In this slide, various list of application is being stated. It is capable of performing sucking and mopping tasks. It is capable of obstacle detection. It is capable of automatic water spraying. It is capable of various cleaning applications in places like hospital, housekeeping, industries, shopping malls, etc. In this slide, various advantage is being listed out. Robotic cleaners save time. Robotic cleaners clean without human interference. Simple in design. Require only weekly maintenance. Can clean underneath of furniture. You can clean your home when you are away from your home. In this slide, various disadvantage is being listed out. Robotic cleaners cannot clean stairs, perform average on soft floors and carpets, can easily stuck up in clutter of wires and threads if any, long time of cleaning as it is automated, too expensive in India, it costs approximately 20,000 rupees to 50,000 rupees. Robotic cleaners have short battery life.
In this slide, we will see a proposed methodology. First, we shortlisted three topics for the capstone project with the help of our project guide. and then discussed on the finalized topic with our project guide, collected different research paper on development of autonomous flow cleaning machine, worked on the design parameters which are related to our project, finalized the material required for the development of autonomous flow cleaning machine, worked on the actual fabrication of the flow cleaning machine, made the proposal and final project report. At the last, it's time for a conclusion. Our thought behind this idea was to make a multidisciplinary machine which has the concepts of various engineering trends, and also wanted to offer this idea to all class of people in our country with efficient way of cleaning in low cost and as much as possible with the exact same intensity that other advanced machines provide which are there out in the market. On the basis of the work done in discussion entitled to final project, it concludes that the project has the scope of development like we can make it more accurate with providing powerful vacuum cleaners, we can upgrade the microcontroller with highest degree of performance, we can also upgrade the machine with more mechanical interference as well as electronic interference. We can also apply mapping as well as camera interference which will give a highest degree of order. Recently, we published a review paper on design and development of autonomous flow cleaning machine in month of March in journal named as IJRASET. So at the end of presentation, my group and I would like to show small gratitude by thanking you all for giving us a chance to present our presentation to you all. So thank you.